Hi guys.
Doesn't have any effects on it right now. It just drives
some dark bass sounds.
Hello guys, welcome.
Hi guys. We're having a breakdown of a song called Free to Go with Heise Kite. And hopefully we are not having a breakdown because this is the first time we did it. So I think it's going to do well. It's been a while, so as you can see on the screen, it's a lot of tracks. I thought we'd start on the verses. We can have a little quick listen.
Thought you were someone. You thought you...
So if we mute the vocals for now, and we can have a look at them later. On the verses, we have a couple of nice Overheim. OB XA, is that correct? Pads?
Yes.
And we have a nice guitar. And we have an arpeggio. Plus some extra nice pads.
Extra nice.
Yeah. And we have this bunch of cinematic keys here. From the bottom, we have this pad from Omnisphere, and we have a choir from Contact, and we have this distorted pad from I think it's Homemade with a nice black hole reverb on it. And I think this pad was from US, but it's a D50 pad from the plugin by Roland. And then we have an arpeggio made by the, I will unfreeze it, and you can see it's from the Diva. Yeah, and we have a nice guitar. It's from a friend of ours, Kid Yoki, who has also produced this record with us. Yeah, I think that's basically it, plus the vocals.
Thought you were someone. You thought you had life.
Should we look at the vocals now? Or do
yeah, it, I think maybe the vocals first, and then we can go into yeah. The rest of it.
The vocals were, I think, recorded by Trom, who is yeah. The second member of Heise Kite. If you look, if you have it in solo.
Thought you were someone.
Let's take the effects first. We have the reverb. It's a sample of the Bricosti reverb from Seventh Heaven.
Yeah.
And there's this nice delay here from, I think, FabFilter.
You
can hear them in the solo.
Yeah.
So only the effects. I think the main reverb is the Bricosti one, yeah. And maybe a couple of others.
This is the Bricosti one in solo.
Nice.
It's really nice. And on the lead vocals, we have some plugins. We have from the beginning. Auto-tune, we have 1176 compressor, a little bit EQ from Ableton. And then again, we have SSL strip, another EQ, LA-2A compressor, another 1176 compressor, we have a DSR, another EQ, hey, another EQ.
Yeah.
And on top of that, I think on the group for the vocals, we have another EQ. So how many EQs do you need for vocals?
You can never have enough.
No. So, well, I think basically that's it on the verses.
Thought you were someone. You thought you had a life. You thought you had a woman. But
some pre-chorus. We added some arpeggios. I think both are from the Diva. This is the first one. And the second one. Combined with the third one that plays the verses. And those three together make a nice vibe. There we have this reverb tail. And also on the pre we have this cinematic vibey stuff as we had on the verses. There comes an additional pad. Nice typical,
it's a typical 80s pad from the Roland D50. It's a Christmas pad.
And also we added the sine wave. And so we have the guitar also playing from the verse. Also the nice pads from the OBXA. And we also added some drums here. You also hear how nice the arpeggio just opens up in filter. And then into the next section of the song that we can call the chorus or the build. So let's look at some of the new stuff that we put on that part. There's another nice keyboard here. Some guitars. So loop the section here. And you also have some sounds from the Prophet 6. Yeah. Some dark bass sounds. And we have a couple of arpeggios. Yeah, that's basically that on the build, and then we go straight into the drop section. This is based around a sample of Ingrid. And it says, did it occur? And if you look in here, it's been played it on the keyboard. And we also added a couple of notes for the vocals. Do you? So it kind of sounds like one instrument. On this part, we have put a lot of plugins on, as usual. It's this one, Camo Fat, without, just to make it a little bit more grippy and crazy, and without nice reverb from Jos. I think we used that one on all the records. And so if you hear it without. It doesn't sound that interesting, but if you put it all in the context with the music. Sounds a little better. And further down we have some drums. And then we have, yeah, I'll take it from the top, we have some it's a pad from
that's the Oberheim.
Yeah, Oberheim pad, and then we have a guitar. Then we have a couple of more guitars. And here we have a synth from the Prophet 6. And we have a piano. The pad. I think this was a Nexus pad, and we have then some arpeggios. Clock. We have a bass. Sorry. More arpeggios here. And I have something here called the Keith Espen, I play it in solo. To make it bounce more if you hear it in solo. And of course we got some sweeps. Right, so on our mix bus we have the Ozon 5, which is has a great impact on the sound. You can hear it without it. And with. Glued it together in a nice way. And also have this one from Slate Digital. It's the FG Red. You can hear it without it. A whip. Makes the drums a little bit better, I would say. And in general, the mix. And listen to his vocals. Also, what makes it sound really good is the harmonies.
I want to know, did it occur to you?
With a lead vocal.
I wanna know, did it occur to you?
Really beautiful.
Yeah.
All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this breakdown. Or is it called breakthrough?
So at least a breakthrough in the amount of tracks.
Yeah, definitely. It is.
Too many.
Yeah.
But they are all needed.
Yeah. Thank you, guys.